Today's announcement will definitely make a huge difference for small and medium-sized businesses who want to grow and take advantage of new technologies. Mais avant de commencer, je veux faire une courte mise à jour sur l'Ukraine. Au cours des derniers jours, j'ai eu différentes conversations avec plusieurs dirigeants mondiaux, incluant Cyril Ramaphosa de l'Afrique du Sud, Macky Sall du Sénégal et Naftali Bennett d'Israël. On a discuté des efforts déployés pour mettre fin à cette invasion illégale de l'Ukraine. Yesterday, I also spoke again with President Zelensky of Ukraine. I applauded his leadership and the courage of Ukrainians. I told him that Canada would continue to be there for them. This morning, Minister Anand announced that we will be supplying more military equipment to Ukraine, including M-72 rocket launchers and grenades. This is an addition to what we've already committed and what we've already sent. We're also ready to welcome more Ukrainians to Canada. For Ukrainians who want to come to our country temporarily, we'll create a Canada-Ukraine authorization for emergency travel. This will eliminate many of the normal visa requirements, and it will be the fastest and safest way to come to Canada. For Ukrainians with family members who are Canadian citizens or permanent residents, we'll implement a special family reunification sponsorship pathway towards permanent residence. Today, Canada and other close partners are calling to suspend Russia from Interpol. We're supporting this because we believe that international law enforcement cooperation depends on a collective commitment to the Universal Declaration of Human Rights and mutual respect between Interpol members. En plus de nos actions pour soutenir l'Ukraine, on s'assure aussi que la Russie soit tenue responsable de ses actes. C'est pourquoi on impose de nouvelles sanctions sur des dirigeants de deux compagnies russes du secteur de l'énergie, Rosneft et Gazprom. Ce matin, la vice-première ministre Freeland a aussi annoncé que le Canada sera le premier pays à révoquer le statut de nation la plus favorisée de la Russie et du Bélarus en tant que partenaires commerciaux. Par conséquent, le Canada va imposer des tarifs de 35% aux exportations provenant de ces deux pays. Ces sanctions ont pour but de mettre encore plus de pression pour que la Russie cesse sa violation de la souveraineté et de l'intégrité territoriale de l'Ukraine. While our government is there to support our partners and allies abroad, we're also continuing our work to support and grow our economy here at home. That's why I'm so happy to be here with you all at Bayview Yards with great news for small businesses. Today, we're joined virtually by Sheena from Nova Scotia, who co-founded her own business called Made with Local. Made with Local is a snack foods company that partners with social enterprises to employ and train Canadians with barriers to the mainstream workforce. Like for many small businesses, the past 2 years hasn't been easy. But despite the challenges, Sheena adapted and made the pivot to digital. Now, with a greater online presence, her company is stronger than ever. Les PME, comme celle de Sheena, sont au cœur de nos communautés. Pendant la pandémie, notre gouvernement a été là pour les soutenir avec des programmes comme la subvention salariale, le compte d'urgence pour les entreprises et l'aide en cas de confinement. Alors qu'on continue de bâtir une relance économique forte, c'est important de s'assurer que les petites entreprises canadiennes aient les outils nécessaires pour réussir dans un monde de plus en plus numérique. Sheena's company benefited from the digital transformation. Today, we want to help other businesses use technology to grow and expand. That's why we're launching the Canada Digital Adoption Program. This is a $4 billion investment that will accelerate the digital transformation of SMEs through grants and loans that meet their needs. For example, if you're looking to grow your business online, you could get a grant that will help with the costs of an e-commerce platform. If your business requires more advanced technologies, you could get a grant to develop a digital adoption plan. And if you need support to implement your digital transformation, you can also apply for a 0% interest loan up to $100,000 from the BDC. Applications for both loans and grants are now open. Si vous êtes une PME, on lance aujourd'hui le programme canadien d'adoption du numérique pour vous. On veut vous aider à faire croître votre entreprise en ligne et à accélérer votre transformation numérique. Durant les 4 prochaines années, on va soutenir jusqu'à 160 000 PME avec des subventions, des prêts et un réseau de conseillers numériques. Le programme va aussi créer des milliers d'emplois, incluant des emplois pour des jeunes experts en numérique qui sont très habiles avec la technologie. Les petites entreprises sont là pour nos communautés et notre gouvernement va continuer d'être là pour elles. Today's announcement is all about empowering small businesses with digital tools so that they can reach their full potential. It's also about building a strong recovery that brings our entrepreneurs and growing companies along. Small businesses are at the heart of our communities, and when they do well, everybody wins.